Today it's early February and we're on this property in southwest Wisconsin, and we're looking at some of the bedding areas that are starting to fill in with some invasive species. And what we're looking to do is to cut out some of these invasives to utilize this area more accordingly to the plan that we have in place on this property. So an area like this specifically, it's starting to be overrun with some ironwood. And the ironwood was somewhat taken care of in years past. It's everywhere. This here, what you're seeing, this would be ironwood. What we're finding is these areas that are really great bedding points on ridge tops and bluff points, some of these areas could be better utilized. And the property owner has this in an MFL program. So part of our service is to comply with that MFL program so that our landowner, our client, is getting the best bang for his buck. In the future, when he wants to do a harvest on this property, he'll have much better timber stands and a much healthier population of trees that are going to meet the species that are going to be more beneficial in the market and more top dollar producing in the market. So some of the areas that we're going to do, for instance, this point is a known bedding area. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to cut out as much of this ironwood as we can. That is the majority of the invasive in this section here. There's other sections of the property where there's some other stuff involved, but we'll get into that at another time. One thing I want to mention is there's a lot of time and effort goes into cutting and spraying stumps. If you take a look around, it really doesn't benefit anything to spray them. You'll kill the stump that's there. However, new shoots within 5 years are going to pop back up anyway. You don't actually kill the plant itself. It comes back. So any invasive work you do, where you're doing TSI, it's going to take some maintenance moving forward. It's not just a one-shot deal, you're done. But in this case, we're not just out here to remove the invasives, but also to improve the area in which we want to replant. I want to be able to put 4-foot oaks in here come spring, and with 10-foot, 12-foot ironwoods growing thick, it's just not going to happen. So that's really kind of what we're looking to do here in this specific spot. In another spot on another date, we'll kind of take you over there and we'll have a look at that. But I just really wanted to touch base on what we're doing here today. Also, by doing this, we're going to open up some areas where we're going to get some regeneration. It's probably going to, some of it's going to be back in ironwood, and I guess we'll take that as habitat until we can figure, you know, the next harvest or the next TSI operation, which will probably be in about 5 years. We've got to get the oaks in here, and we're going to put some more cherry up in this area as well. But anyway, that's kind of a little bit of an insight on what we have going on here. If this is a service that we do offer, to have us come out and take care of the invasives, your forester, there is a cost share on that. Most landowners do get reimbursed to a certain amount. You can hire us. The DNR, Wisconsin DNR, will honor our invoice as part of your work efforts towards the MFL program that you're in. And most of them are perfectly fine with reimbursement of some sort or paying the landowner for his efforts. It's kind of a win-win for all. We're going to get some better planting in here, some better tree species. We're also looking on the other end of the property, which we'll get to at another day. We're looking to put some more cedar in that on this west facing ridge. There's quite a bit of mature cedar over there right now. However, it is starting to die out, and we're hoping to get some new ones in there this spring. So we're going to have to do about somewhat the same idea as we did here, and we'll have to do some clearing over there so we can get them, the new cedars, in there to produce and survive for a period of time. So that's kind of an insight on what we're doing. If you have any questions, or if you are interested in doing some TSI on your property, feel free to give us a call. You can always message us or check us out on the website and kind of see how we're doing and what our scheduling is like. But typically, if a landowner calls, we'll try to get you roped in with the rest of the properties throughout the state. So any questions, feel free to ask.